Hey everybody, this is Laird of Garskaden, and what a beautiful day it is today outside here in the USA. It's about 71 degrees right now. It's pretty cool. Anyway, I wanted to make a video to, it's going to be a video response to my previous video called Turkish People, and I got to make this because I'm having to write so many comments where I say the same thing over and over again. I'm sure a lot of people can relate to this, so they want to make a video that just says the comment in a video, and that way they don't have to constantly repeat themselves. It's an energy saver that way. So, first of all, with the last video, Turkish People, yes, I am overgeneralizing, and that's partly because I'm very frustrated with the people that I have to deal with in the comments section. They're very ignorant, willfully ignorant, and that brings out a lot of logical fallacies in me, and I really become very emotional and just really angry. I'm very angry at ignorance because I see these people as contributing to a future genocide. So that's the reason why I'm overgeneralizing. I don't want to take the video down, you know, too lazy, and there's too many comments attached to it that are very valuable. But anyway, to counteract this overgeneralizing thing that I have two examples of really, really spot-on Turks that, you know, really have their heads screwed on straight. They're very, very reasonable, and they deny the Armenian genocide. And their names are Turkish Van Chickens, who, when I looked on his sort of YouTube homepage, he's 15 years old. And he was saying things like, you're being very unreasonable, you shouldn't be overgeneralizing, and he was making good kind of pwnage statements towards me. And I was like, wow, you know, you're very, very reasonable. I disagree with you on why you deny the Armenian genocide, and here's why. So I've had to get a response from him. But yeah, he seems like a very reasonable guy, and I commend him. And the other one is, I'm going to mispronounce this, but it's Ucaneloy, or Ucaneloy, I don't know how you pronounce it, but he's right now sending me a lot of stuff that's really cool, like English translations of Ottoman archives and other websites and movies and books and things that all deny the Armenian genocide, and I'm reading them, and of course, I'm like, well, some of this is kind of enlightening. For example, one is you really kind of learn more about the Armenian rebel parties like the Dashnaks and the Hunchakist parties, and yeah, they were pretty terrible. I'd have to agree, just based on what I've seen from this, they are pretty terrible. But you have to realize that, and this is all another thing that I need to say. Yeah, they were pretty bad, but they did not represent Armenian popular opinion, and in fact, they were a very, very, very small percentage of the Armenian population. You can't say that they represent all Armenians. And really, it's just the Dashnak rebel party that was really active in trying to, you know, sabotage things. And really, you know, the fullest extent, the biggest thing that they could possibly do was organize a defense of, you know, two villages, Zaytun and Van. They couldn't overthrow the government, and they couldn't do anything. They were too small in number, and eventually they were, you know, kind of defeated. You know, the Turks eventually did get their way. So trying to say that, you know, the Armenians are all evil, look how many people they massacred. No. You're talking about just the Dashnaks and the Hunchakist, and really the Hunchakist were, you know, pretty peaceful, and as far as I can tell. The Dashnaks were the only ones who were very violent. That still does not take away from the genocidal intent and the genocide of the Armenians by the Ottomans, or the Turks in this case. So I don't know what they're trying to say with that. I guess they're trying, and that actually fits in another thing here. A lot of Turks are have this thing in their head. There's this dichotomy between Turks and Armenians, and so they constantly feel like they need to balance it out, like, oh, maybe the Turks are bad, but so are the Armenians. So in their minds, there's kind of this balancing thing, and so maybe that's why they're trying to say that the Dashnaks and the Hunchakists, oh, they're so terrible, you know, and so it's just a humanitarian catastrophe. That's a false dichotomy. That's a logical fallacy. These two people, these two groups, I'm sorry, weren't the only ones who were paying attention to the Armenian genocide when it was happening. In fact, there were numerous European countries who were there, you know, with missionaries and foreign ambassadors who were there recording what was going on while it was happening. We have Ambassador Morgenthau from America, you know, taking a lot of notes. He wrote his book called Story, which is basically everything that he saw. We have French ambassadors and whatnot. We have missionaries. And the point is, there's this false dichotomy, and they want to say that, oh, the Ottoman archives are open, but why not the Armenian archives? And they want to say the Ottoman archives are the only ones that count. We have European archives and American archives that are all legitimate, and all eyewitness testimonies, telegrams, pictures and whatnot, you know, from Germany and America, everywhere, okay? You can't just say the Ottoman archives are the only ones that count. Granted, there's some pretty interesting stuff in there, but you can't just say that this is the only thing that matters. There's too much evidence besides the Ottoman archives and besides the so-called, you know, Armenian archives, okay? You're not going to overthrow all that evidence. 41 countries worth, okay? Goodness gracious. Now, let's see. Okay, people have been telling me that I haven't been supporting my videos with evidence. I'll say this for like the billionth time in my comments, but now I can finally put it in video form. YouTube is too narrow of a medium to put all of the nitty-gritty details that are required to prove that the Armenian genocide happened, okay? Most people need a book length, to put all the nitty-gritty details in there. So what I do, which is much more efficiently, is to put in sparse details, but leave the details for the comments. So when somebody says that's not true, I can go in with the proper details, and it's a lot more efficient, and I can quickly just say there, and that's why I'm right. So I just want to say, look, if you're looking for evidence from me, all you got to do is ask me a question, and then I will provide the evidence if you ask for it, and I'll provide the details to make my point clear. So I have that, and this is just efficiency's sake. Okay, and a lot of these Turks, not counting Turkish fan chickens and Ukraine loy, it seems to me, and this is just my opinion, they quickly realize, you know, they think that I don't know what I'm talking about because I'm not providing evidence, I guess, from my videos or something. They think that I'm just another ignorant Armenian or a Turk. And another thing, I'm not Armenian or Turkish. I'm 75% Scottish and 25% Chinese, and I live in America. I've been to Turkey, you know, 3 times, okay? So that's another thing I wanted to clear up. People keep asking me, are you Armenian or Turkish? No, I'm not. You know, kind of, it should look like that, in my opinion. I don't look anything like a Turk or an Armenian. But anyway, these Turks, besides Turkish fan chickens and Ukraine loy, I think they realize how quickly learned I am on this topic, and that I'm not pulling this out of thin air, that I have read about 12 books that are historically scholarly, you know, college level. I kind of know what I'm talking about. And then they just be quiet. They just shut up. They realize I'm extremely analytical and committed to truth. But some people don't shut up, and they just keep yakking ignorance at me, and they don't address what I say. It gets really frustrating. Anyway, that's the video I wanted to make. I hope this clears up a lot of things so I don't have to keep repeating myself over and over. This is Laird of Grasscotton signing out.